is when attacking. The attack occurred approximately 200 kilometers north of the country's capital, Niamey, in the northwest Niger, according to the statement from Africa Command. It goes on. It goes on, but as this is coming up here, okay. So we're seeing right now this right now, this right. Right. So we're taking people that are trapped. Fire to take. And said those were killed and those were wounded. We're taking. Say what? Right. Right. Okay. So the attack occurred approximately 200 kilometers north of the country's capital. Now, so what does that mean in terms of where Mr. Johnson was? Because they didn't find him until how many hours later? 48 hours later. And mind you, a significant distance away from where the fire, the attack, actually was. Okay.
I said he might have been still alive when they took him and they were using friends for ransom and decided to kill him after all.
But how did they take him? That's what I'm saying. How did you separate them that way, right? You understand what I'm saying? That's what's so fishy about the whole situation. And that just doesn't sound right. There are U.S. troops and the U.S. military maintaining presence in the Northwest African country on 5 years of smart moves of U.S. special operations forces advising local troops to get battle to terrorist groups. ISIS and Boko Haram on both fronts. Boko Haram, of course, you know, is in Nigeria. Primarily known to operate in Nigeria. And MI, round four, right? And then, of course, you have the folks from ISIS who come here basically from the north. Primarily from the north. And they are coming down into the area known as Niger, right? So, Niger is an important part of the world. You have a deep relationship with Lieutenant General Kenneth McKenzie, the director of the drugs there, told reporters that the people are on Thursday. Alright, so we can into that relationship and believe that they are as well. In fact, I think it's very good that we're a success story yet. A success story. Before I go on, let's take these phone calls. Because it gets worse. This is not good at all. There is no silver lining to any of this. So I'm just letting you know right now, we're just warming up right on Sunday morning on the floor of the state. As you can see, we're researching this thing further, and we're not gonna stop until we get to the bottom of this thing. So let's take these phone calls.
Alright. Let's go and talk to a veteran in Marion County named Mark.
Thanks, guys. I just wanted to begin with, because you've already touched on the subject, about 90% of France's power comes from nuclear power, and they get about 100% of their uranium from Nigeria. I think I'll take another step back and step over and listen back to Donald Trump and put Chad on the travel cast list only 2 weeks before the attack. Chad was providing intelligence in the area for the Americans and the Nigerians. So when they withdrew themselves from the area, they left the hookers vulnerable to an attack on the observation. What I think would happen to Sergeant David Jump, he was with he was in the ranks of all the people. Well, E6 is already a sergeant, so he was operating command E6. E6 is a big promotion in any rank of service. You're considered a staff, not a mission officer staff. So you can, your career balance is fine. Johnson knew that you came to final assault, you got a flank grip. So Johnson being, I'm presuming, one of the younger of the girls in lower rank, maybe an American. He blamed him and to travel. I have a mile on foot in your gear. It's going to take about 15 minutes. So it's not unlikely that, unfortunately, he probably got hit in the field with a counterfire. I'm sure he was wide enough to go when it opened fire on your flank, your enemy. You just don't start. You're not shooting at your left. You're trying to get around them. So they tell however wide their front was. They're front attack towards the Americans. He had to get to one side or the other of them. In the process, he had to loop way around to keep himself alive. And he trains to know. He's not shooting at any moving. Now he got close. He may have been laid out by the enemy and hit. So, and it might take on. I have a feeling one reason that his wife wasn't allowed to see him is that once he was down, they butchered him out of retaliation. And then they got shot. That was a mistake in this coffee. That would be my take on. I don't know that's being happened. You know, they were tiny people from the very beginning. And women of Spanish officers are in that area. But then they forgot the known problem that I'll share with the listeners. The Chinese, you look at the two Djibouti, but investing $5 billion to a huge port facility, and they're running a transcontinental high-speed train across Africa, all across Africa, with highways, the Jake Swift, intercepting, I just want to say $150 or $100 billion across Africa. It's a chase for middle price, which is why you look at all our copies that we need from here, from continent, England, and Africa, United, which I would personally support, and he was executed for that opinion. He was the entire dynamite fighter. And that's all our copies that we removed, and Africa was eliminated at the same time, I'm saying that they did. But there's economy playing, the World Bank, and the monetary fund, and those are all right. China's one thing China's doing, that the Americans are not making investments. If the Americans used to do it, when the Americans were found their country, give your resources. We used to be trying to bring in the United States International Development Resource and friendly military advisors that we're not necessarily there. You pretty much way today. We're still chasing it, no price tag, focus on. We ain't doing it anymore. The Chinese are still building schools and roads, etc. I'm going to go with it, but we're living. And who just said that? Let the card just said that a week ago, right? And I got it. It's right. We are fighting the second wave. It's wrong. It's March. America's fighting the second wave position. We have no leverage over the Chinese when it comes to North Korea. Donald Trump is a serious threat to world stability. So, we're just here to help you. I'm going to take over there, and I'm going to anyway, I'm going to get over there, but I serve them primarily as those Japanese military fighters that are trying to take any case,
it makes a lot of sense.
Industries. And the fact of the matter is, there's a statement that we have to remember, stories that remind us, Africa has
proving itself to be a graveyard of cultures. So if you go ahead and act wrong, you know, people don't fix it. That's what the Nigerians have been doing. You know, they understood the extractive nature of ExxonMobil. And so they would go ahead and go and extract that oil and gas themselves. And they would decide that you're not going to get rich while we sit here poor and without power in our own land. So you know, I mean, power in all sense of the word.
Resources back on that nature. The first thing that happens is the old USA, of course, you know, the good old USA gets into it, and they're like, oh, well, you're an alien state. Now you're a murderer. All of a sudden, you're a murderer.
Yeah, but the market people, all of a sudden, like a circle of people in the country.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
I mean, humanitarianism, we knew, even in the 90s, they were going to get exploited humanitarianism as an excuse for invasion. So,
I think Mark made a good point as well when he
talked about what Chinese are doing that we used to do. We would have peace for, you know, but you know, we have the ruling class in this country that is only profit driven and is only selfish, but everybody's self-interested.
Yeah, sure, yeah.
Everybody's got their kind of lives for purpose. You know, and so there's a way to miles than the people's will. Right here, we're giving you this. They're extracting billions of dollars, but you're giving you this, charity here that we're doing bad for.
So we want to talk about the backlash and things. Alright, so folks, please bear with us. 813-239-9663. Let's click the line. Let's get to it.
Brother Ryan, Mango.
What's going on, brother?
Hey, man. We got to get you home with this. Not even the power. I appreciate Mark. And I certainly appreciate the lady. You know, the lady. That's helping him. And I ain't going to disrespect none of that. Because I'm a veteran as well. So you got three in a row. Let's dig up.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Thank
you. I got grown up one time to be a Mexican. I'm a guy. I'm going to be on these phones. And I already know I can ask a call for it. And if they take that. And I don't know. I'm a Mexican. I'm just a recruit. I'm going to do stuff. Okay, but
you make a good point. You
twisted, brother. They got a little bit of twisted in for weeks as a community. And it's something like, you know, I'm not going to marry somebody out of their head. And he's saying something that's not proper either. Like, people ask me, I'm not really saying something about something like somebody in the job or something. I'm like, why would I have been out of communication? I'm saying this to myself, bro. Well, now, if all of this comes out, I'll be all this connected to the human.
Sure, thank you, man. Listen, thank you very much, bro. Appreciate it. We're going to go and take a break.
Okay. When it's inside the election right now, inside the election, we have to do it real. So, all right, so we have established that.
Say they don't want us to unite. Who do you believe they is? Any one of you.
They is?
Yes. You know, Bob Marley and the song, they don't want us to unite.
Well, you tell us who you
all
think they is.
All they want us to do is keep on busting in our faces.
Well, of course.
You think that they is?
The they that Bob Marley was referring to was the white man.
Really?
Yeah, because the powers.
Top ranking, bro. The name of the song is Top Ranking.
That's what Bob Marley would have been talking about, you know.
Really? That's the name of the song, man. Top ranking.
He got the power class. Who has the power? What's the power
then?
I don't think he's trying to talk. I think he's trying to sing.
Yeah, that's what he's trying to do. So what we got, man?
You got any
Burton
on the other?
Yeah, kind of.